In this video, I show you how I build the world's simplest electrically driven gate using only 4 components and a budget of $50. Based on this video, you can also build your own version. First, we need a gear motor. This motor will open and close our gate. This one was originally a barrier motor, but I have also built gates using grinder motors and other slow gear motors. The most economical and easiest solution is to use a low-speed grinder motor from Lidl. This motor costs around $50, and it is a very reliable motor for our gate. This motor normally works on 3-phase power, but I will use it on single-phase power. We will also need a capacitor. We will need one relay, we will need one son-off smart relay, and we will need 2 limit switches. These limit switches will detect the open and close positions of the gate. From the son-off devices, we should choose one that works not only by Wi-Fi, but also by RF remote control. These are very useful devices. I have automated almost my entire house using them. This smart relay costs around $7. It connects to our home Wi-Fi network, and we can control the gate from our mobile phone or control anything connected to it. The power supply is 220 volts, and this power can be switched remotely. I also ordered the RF remote control from AliExpress for about $2. Teaching the remote control to the device is very easy. To pair a button, we simply press the button on the remote and the button on the device at the same time. A red LED light shows when the pairing is finished. Now we need one normally open contact and one normally closed contact, so we will use a relay controlled by the son-off switch. If we want to run the motor on single-phase power, instead of 3-phase, we must connect it as follows. First, we need a capacitor to create an auxiliary phase for the motor. The 2 wires of the capacitor are connected to any 2 terminals of the motor. Then the neutral wire is connected to the 3rd free terminal of the motor. The rotation direction of the motor depends on which capacitor wire receives the phase wire. This direction change is handled by the normally closed and normally open contacts of the relay. When the relay is activated, the motor rotates in the opening direction. When the relay is in its normal state, the motor rotates in the closing direction and moves the gate. When the finished remote-controlled relay is connected into the motor circuit, we can change the rotation direction of the motor using a remote control. As long as the limit switches are not built into the circuit, the motor will rotate for an unlimited time. The limit switches will stop the motor operation in both directions. My current automatic gate has been operating since the year 2020. It is controlled by a 4-channel son-off device. Because I am dismantling the distribution cabinet where the control electronics are located, I am now building this single-phase system. By the way, the 3-phase version is also a very simple construction. There is a video about it on my YouTube channel. Over 5 years, it has completed more than 3,000 opening and closing cycles. I am just saying this to show that it performed all 3,000 openings without any failure. I doubt that factory-made gate openers could produce a longer lifespan or higher reliability than these homemade versions. I disconnected the original 3-phase wiring and I am now checking whether it works with a single phase. For now, I am testing the motor directly from a wall socket to see if the auxiliary phase motor has enough torque to move the gate. Interestingly, in delta connection mode, which is the 220 volt operating mode, the motor runs quietly and smoothly, but the direction change is not stable. If I change the rotation direction while the motor is running, the auxiliary fast is not able to reverse the momentum of the motor and it continues rotating in the same direction with star connection, which is theoretically the 400 volt mode. The direction change works perfectly, but the motor has a bad sound. Now that I have confirmed that the gate can be operated from 220 volts, the conversion can begin. It will get an outdoor enclosure where I will handle the wiring. I already installed the power supply conduit pipe in the spring. Finally, since the new electronics were completed, there have already been 216 opening cycles. Although I had some doubts about the durability of the relay, I was positively surprised and it looks like it can handle the load. The relay is rated for 12 amperes of current, while the motor does not draw more than 4 amperes, not even during startup. Despite this, the motor load is inductive in nature, which has a very negative effect on the lifetime of the contact pairs during switching and disconnection moments. And my worm gear motor gate opener electronics are also finished. Here, because the project had a low budget, I used a steel wire rope instead of a chain. It bounces a little, but overall it works quite well. The motor is very slow and the gate has an opening length of 4 meters, so it takes some time until it fully opens. If you enjoyed my content, please leave a comment, like the video, and subscribe to the channel.